Good morning, good morning, good morning, people. This is The Pen, Cliff Radio Live this morning. I'm doing this because I wanted to go over a topic that we spoke about this morning, and which, of course, I know some people can't watch the video, so I've got to provide the audio source for you as well. Perhaps you have your headphones in, and you just wanted to stop and take a quick listen as to what we talk about. I won't be before you very long, but nonetheless, I kind of wanted to share the thought for the day. Oftentimes, you know, let me just start here. Last night I went on a date with my wife and, you know, it was an awesome time. And it's a time when you get to share your thoughts as a friend, across the table, you know, next to each other. And we just really get to talk, and which ultimately creates a romantic environment that we seek. We don't have to force it, but nonetheless, we create it. So I had an awesome time. So I just want to spin off into a conversation that led to us talking this morning. You know, when you have great dialogue, it always leads to the morning after conversation. So woke up and we begin to talk about, you know, feelings and the blind experiences you have in feelings. And traditionally, you might hear that love is blinding. But nonetheless, you also quickly realize that all emotions are blinding. And what we mean by that is that whenever you're dealing with your emotions up front and they're leading you, you have a tendency to not hear things the way that we should, not see things the way that we should, and not say things the way that we should. But love is not the only emotion that has the ability to blind us. You can be blinded by anger. You can be blinded by excitement. You could be blinded by depression. You could be blinded by your shyness, by fear. Whatever emotion you can think of, if it's not properly handled, then you can find yourself being blinded or deafened by those emotions. So it's important for us to understand what emotions are. And I think the, you know, when we meet people and we see them to be emotionally driven or emotional wreck, it's the byproduct is that they didn't really know who they don't really know what emotions are themselves. So I just wanted to touch on my rendition of what emotions are. What I believe emotions are, I believe that emotions are the alarm systems for our inner being, for who we are as a person, for our soul, for our spirit. And what this is designed to do is your emotions are designed to, first and foremost, to get your attention. You know, just because something gets your attention doesn't mean that your next step is going to be an erratic one. It should be a calculated one. Your emotions are the alarm systems to your rational thinking or your rational response. But most times we don't use it that way. We let our emotions lead us and we go into panic mode. Now, I want to use the word panic mode does not necessarily mean it's always in response and what we equate to be negative, but sometimes it is an overexcitement of an emotion, or it causes us to kind of ignore some of the things we were once paying attention to. That's what panic is. When people panic, they don't pay attention to the barriers or the rules anymore. They just respond. So when I say that, I want you to keep that in mind. So we get to the point of emotions, right? And the emotions are supposed to be the alarm system for every idea, every thought, every moral system that we have. And an example of love, what ends up happening right away is that we start to get that little tingly feeling that none of us can explain, but we've all felt before. And rather than assessing it with what we really want out of a person, we allow ourselves to ride the wave because it feels good. It's euphoric when we experience it. And being that it's euphoric, it's kind of like being on a natural high. You allow it to govern your next step rather than saying, okay, now that I feel this, what is going on in one of two places? One being what's going on in the inside of me. What is it that I said that I wanted in my rational mindset before I felt this? And the next one is, what is going on with the person that I'm experiencing this with? I want to see them in the truest form and fashion and light. That way I make good, sound decisions about my relationship endeavors moving forward. But what we do is we abandon ship. We have this list of do's and don'ts and wills and won'ts. But yet when we start to feel that little tingly feeling called love, suddenly we don't pay attention to the list anymore. And then fast forward months or years later, we find ourselves heartbroken and hurt by the person. And we think that they've changed. But the problem is, normally they have not changed. They've always been that person. But we've allowed that emotional feeling to blind us and to deafen us to what we knew we wanted. But so is such other feelings as well. Anger is a big culprit of that. Oftentimes we allow frustration, which is the first sign that you need to pay attention, we allow it to fester and turn into this blinding feeling called love. I mean, I'm sorry. This blinding feeling called anger, and then it moves to hatred. So if you don't know this, there's a progressive growth in that emotional state. I'm probably going to write that down and come back later and go over all the progressive growth of emotions. But this one in particular is the one that's probably the most damaging, because it starts off with irritation and moves to frustration. And then moves to dislike, then it moves to anger, then it moves over into the realm of hate. And as you progressively are going deeper into that, you find yourselves becoming a character that you really, really don't want to be. Once again, that initial emotion was to alert you as to what's happening in you and outside of you, so that you can calculate a reasonable next rational step before it progresses to the worst case. So I just wanted to put that out there today, that your emotions are the alarms that you should pay attention to. Just like when you're driving down the road and you're hearing the ambulance, you know, I watch people, you know, the traffic's coming towards you, ambulance going the opposite direction you're going, but yet the people that's heading in the same direction you are pull on the side of the road, which is basically a useless movement, because it doesn't benefit anyone at that point. Rather, it compromises the traffic flow on your side of the road for no reason, because the ambulance wasn't heading your way. When you hear that alarm, you should first and foremost pay attention to what's happening and examine your surroundings. Look at what's going on around you to make sure that you're making the best decision before proceeding. So when it catches your attention, it automatically should slow you down. But what we do, it shouldn't stop you automatically. I'm not saying that every time you feel an emotion, you should stop. It should cause you to become attentive and aware and to recognize what's happening. Because when that alarm, when that ambulance is passing, that police car is passing, and you hit alarm, you pay attention, and you begin to think, I wonder where they're going. I wonder what happened. And that's the transition of the emotional alarm moving over to the rational thinking, so that you can make the best decision moving forward. But for those who are not thinking like that, they just pull on the side of the road, and they're sitting down, and they're like, oh, what's going on? It frightened me. It startled me. So now they're being led by their emotions, and they don't make the best decision when they're handling that kind of situation. And we do the same with our lives. And that's how we end up in, no pun intended, emotional wrecks, because we allow our emotions to stop us and prohibit us rather than to alarm us, so that we can be more attentive and reasonable in our next decision making. So look, guys, I just want to drop that on you real quick. I don't want it to be lengthy. I'm going to try to get this podcast going on a consistent basis so you can enjoy Cliff Radio just like you enjoy Cliff TV. And this is all stemming from The Pen. We are the Personal Empowerment Network agency. I want to encourage you to attend some of our free seminars. We have a free seminar coming up on March 16th at 6:30 p.m. located at the Lafayette Public Library, South Regional Location, 6101 Johnson Street, Lafayette, Louisiana, 70503. If you need additional information, feel free to text me or call me at 337-296-2262, or you can email me at cliff@thepenetworkteam.com. So look, guys, I thank you for listening in. I want to hit you up with more great topics and conversations. We got a lot planned this year in the upcoming months, so stay tuned to Cliff Radio by The Pen. You have an awesome day. Oh, I almost lost it. Gotta remember what I always say, right? Be blessed, don't stress, do your best, and let God do the rest. You guys have a great day.